The map of Grand Theft Auto 4's Liberty City is gorgeous. It's so densely packed with detail and monuments, it truly feels like a real city. And what a fair bit of people know is that the original map was going to contain countryside, pretty much 3 states worth of stuff to explore. However, there's already dozens of unfinished interiors you can look at in the game right now. So today, we're going to look at those unfinished interiors. Let's take a look at this building for example. This one you can see from the outside, it has stairs and an empty doorway. Another thing you can see is the second floor. Unfortunately, there's no way to get in without mods, and even if there was, the floor has no collision, so I'll just be using a free camera mod. Heading inside, we can see the lights from my NRG900 that's outside goes through for some reason. We can also see this gated window, and then turning around there's this unbelievably large doorway and some stairs. The room to the left is pretty boring, same with the big ass doorway room, but this is one of my favorite interior layouts just because of the upstairs room. You can peer down and look outside. I mean, who knows what this interior could have been used for? The layout of the upstairs room kind of reminds me of the Trashmaster interior in Algonquin, with the upstairs bit with the windows. Then the downstairs sort of reminds me of the apartment in the Mission Concrete Jungle. There's quite a few more in Bohan, but my next favorite is one you can actually enter. It's near the strip club. Just jump on this wall thing, but be sure not to hold the sprint key while you do this, because if you do that, you'll just jump over like this. Next, jump on this ledge, and then move towards the window and get up there. The ground has collision, however the second floor does not. It's a pretty useless interior, it's not really filled with anything, but it's a good camping spot if you want to go on a cop rampage or something. Now there is a top floor that you can get into. You can get in there if you get on the roof with something like a helicopter, then go over here and then jump down, then again go over here, again jump down, and then go through the window. Now for this floor, there is these areas near the windows where it's just empty. The top floor is really not as reliable since the bottom of the floor can actually be shot through for some reason, and that's about all there is, but I think this one is really cool since you can camp here and it is enterable without mods. There's also quite a few locations in Bohan where the windows have these arches inside of them, which makes them look like they have some depth from the outside. I doubt this was meant to be a full-on interior, but why is this one of the few locations in the entire map where this is a thing? There's also this building right here. It's actually really easy to see this one. It's right near the stunt jump. Through the windows on the roof, you can see into these interiors. Inside of the north interior, there's a fat wad of just nothing. However, on the outside, there's an elevated door and 2 windows, so it doesn't really correspond with the inside. On the south interior, there's a shutter and then there's an empty doorway. Well, it's actually not empty. It's only from this side. However, on the other side of the building, it does correspond well since it is an actual shutter this time. So this makes me think it could have possibly been used for Stevie's car thefts or something. Another thing that's really interesting about Bohan is that if you use a save editor, you can close off the island, just like how they are with Algonquin and Alderney when you first start the game. So this makes me think that midway through development, it was locked at the beginning, but they just removed it. I mean, you go to Bohan so early on in the game, it just makes sense, I guess. Despite Roman saying in the first mission, you can't go across bridges, so good. Now, as a quick bonus, if we move all the way to Algonquin, there's this building near the docks. This is another case where you can see inside of the building from outside, however you can't get in without mods. Now what makes this so interesting is that it's thought to be a ferry of some sort. Now if you want to know or just see more, I'll have 2 videos regarding ferries linked in the description. They're both made by Badger Goodger. That's all we're going to look at today. There is more unfinished stuff in the game, obviously, but I'm not going to go over all of them right now. And yeah, bye.